Do you know how to add text to your photos? Howdy y'all, in this video we're gonna cover how you can add text into your photos, but it just depends on how you want to do it or go about it. So let's get started. If you want to simply add a signature or watermark to one or more photos, use the Manager module. But if you want to play around with it just a bit more, like adding an outline, then you should definitely use the Develop module. And if you want to apply certain text effects and some magic touches, you're gonna have to go to the Editor module. Now, if you already know how you plan on using your text, you can skip ahead and go straight to where you need to in the timeline in the video description. So let's look at each module in greater detail. For example, if you want to add a signature to a batch of photos, go to the Manager module under Edit, click Text Overlay, or use the keyboard shortcut Control and T. Your options for modifying text are quite limited here. This is where you paste your text, select the font, size, color, and placement of the text. And this is where you check if you want to use it as a watermark. If you want to learn more about watermarks, we did a video on that as well. You'll find it here and also in the description. Now with this method, it's very important to remember that when you click apply, your files are going to be overwritten. So it's better to use the tool on copies of originals and have the originals backed up somewhere. Another way to add text is using the annotation tool in the Develop module. Now you can find this in Zona Photo Studio X by clicking Preferences, Other, and then select Show Tools for Work with Documents in Develop. Now annotation gives you a few more options for working with text. It's easier to modify, move, or even add an outline. A minor drawback is resizing the text. You have to resize in the right panel, and because dragging these edge points only changes the size of the text box. However, a big advantage of the Develop module is that adjustments are, as usual, non-destructive. If you want to change something in the text, you can go back at any time. Now, if you're interested in learning or how to use various options in the annotations tool, we've done a video on that as well. You'll find it here as well as in the description. And now let's check out how you can tinker around more with text and have more fun in the Editor module. So at first glance, the text options may seem limited, but don't let yourself be fooled. The first major advantage is that you can resize text by dragging these outer points. Unless you have a specific text size that you need to adhere to for your client, you don't have to resize using these values. But the biggest advantage of this method is going to be the text effects and working with text in layers. If you use effects, you can see that you can not only add an outline to the text, but also use many other useful effects. For example, adding a gradient to the text where you select the colors you want and specify the direction of the gradient. You can also add a glowing effect or shadow where you specify the direction and length. Now you can also create text using photos or design invitations for an event. Now we actually have videos for these last two options I mentioned, and you know where to find them. So that you don't lose your work and can return to your adjustments in the editor, I recommend saving your photos as a .zps file as well. This way, when you reopen the file, you keep all the layers and can make any changes as you need. All right, so those are just some simple ways of how you can operate and play around with text in Zona Photo Studio X. I hope this was a useful tip. Let us know what you think below, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care.